Hello, this is day 11 of Bible in 1 year. So, yesterday it was a Sunday, so hopefully you've been to church and you studied the Word of God and listened to some preaching to know more about the Word of God. So for today, our Bible text are Genesis chapters 27 to 28, and then we have Matthew chapter 8 verses 18 to 34. Okay, so it's a bit of reflection. Yesterday during service, the topic in the morning is about giving. So basically, giving is you're giving a portion of your blessings to God. You're returning a portion of what He gave to you. And it's not paying God back, because, you know, you can't pay God back. Everything is owned by God. Everything came from God. So it's just a matter of showing your gratitude to God by giving back a portion of what you receive from Him. Okay, so if you're a Christian, you have that acknowledgement that everything you receive comes from God, or everything you receive came from God. Okay, and you know you have God has this commandment for us to support His work. You know, the church, the missions, and we do that by giving a portion of our blessings to the church. Okay, some people would not understand that, what do you call it, principle? Is it a principle, that lesson? They would be skeptical about it. They would think that, you know, maybe the church is not using it for the missions. Maybe some people are pocketing the money. Okay, to non-Christians, they would have those thoughts, you know, those doubts. But to a Christian, especially kung alam mo naman kung ano yung ginagawa talaga ng church mo, kita mo naman na ginagawa talaga for, you know, the work of God, to reach more people, to win more souls. And kita mo naman talaga na may pinagkakagastosan talaga yung church, binibigay talaga sa missionary yung portion na binibigay ng mga members, ng mga visitors, ng mga attend. So, in that case, di ba, you put your faith in God, and kumbaga, pag nagbigay ka, you're giving it to God, and then, kung sino yung pinagkatiwalaan nung perang binigay mo, di ba, siya na yung sasagot kay God. Siya yung magiging accountable kay God kung ginamit pa talaga siya sa gawain ng Panginoon or hindi. Okay? So, you don't need to, kumbaga, after you give it to God. Okay. And then after that, si God nang bahala. Okay. Parang ganun yung thinking ko. Okay, this is just my own view on the matter. Okay. Pero ako ganun. Sa pagkakaintindi ko, pagkakaunawa. Okay, so for today, have a new text. Let's pray muna before we delve into it. Our Father, we thank you for the blessings that you've showered upon us. Thank you for allowing us to understand the importance of giving, of supporting your work, so that more souls would be, it's a privilege to be able to contribute in reaching more souls, especially mga missionaries, especially mga church workers who do visitation every week. And we thank you, Lord, for everything that you've given us, for the blessings that are allowing us to be able to give back to you as well, for giving us our needs, for providing our needs. So thank you, Lord, for everything that you've done for us. And in matter of trials, we also thank you for allowing us to go through them, for us to know you more, to understand what you want for us in our lives. And thank you for allowing us to grow as Christians, for allowing us to learn lessons from those trials that you've given us. And Lord, we thank you for another day, another chance to serve you, to do something worthwhile in our lives. And we pray that you would guide us. Pray that, excuse me, we pray that you would bless our work, bless our activities for today, and you would give us wisdom, guidance, so that ang aming pong gawain ay maging matuwid, maging naayon po sa inyong kagustuhan. I also pray, Lord, for health, safety, and protection of our family, salvation of our lost loved ones, and I pray as well for the recovery, continued recovery of my father and all the others who are sick. And I pray as well, Lord, for strength for those who needed it, especially my pastors, church workers, and the missionaries. Continue to guide them, Lord, so that they would continue in your work. And thank you, Lord. Just say, I thank you for everything, Lord. And we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. P.S. again. As we read your word today, Lord, just let the Holy Spirit work in us so that we would be able to understand the message and apply it in our lives, Lord. Thank you. This pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. So sometimes, sorry, before I read the text, another segue. There was one time when we had a seminary, and one of the activities is to pray by simply thanking God for everything that you've received, all the blessings. And personally, it feels much better than, you know, supplication. Kasi, in a way, meron kang, makikita mo ba yung history yung mga times na tinulungan ka ng Panginoon, and you're very thankful for everything that He did for you, and that you know, based on those experiences, that God will not forsake you, God will not leave you, and in your current trials and in the future trials to come, you know that God will not leave you, that God will still be there for you, and He will still help you. There will still be more things to be thankful about. Okay, so that's it. Segue lang, ano. Kasi sometimes when I pray, that na-stuck ako dun sa thank you. Thank you for everything, thank you for all the things that you've missed. Alright, Genesis chapter 27 and 28. And it came to pass that when Isaac was old and his eyes were dim, so that he could not see, he called Esau, his eldest son, and said unto him, My son. And he said unto him, Behold, here am I. And he said, Behold, now I am old, I know not the day of my death. Now therefore take, I pray thee, thy weapons, thy quiver, and thy bow, and go out to the field, and take me some venison, and make me savory meat such as I love, and bring it to me that I may eat, that my soul may bless thee before I die. And Rebekah heard when Isaac spake to Esau his son, and Esau went to the field to hunt for venison and to bring it. And Rebekah spake unto Jacob her son, saying, Behold, I heard thy father speak unto Esau thy brother, saying, Bring me a venison, and make me savory meat that I may eat, and bless thee before the Lord before my death. Now therefore, my son, obey my voice according to that which I command thee. Go now to the flock, and fetch me from thence two good kids of the goats, and I will make them savory meat for thy father, such as he loveth. And thou shalt bring it to thy father, that he may eat, and that he may bless thee before his death. And Jacob said to Rebekah his mother, Behold, Esau my brother is a hairy man, and I am a smooth man. My father peradventure will feel me, and I shall seem to him as a deceiver. And thou shalt bring a curse upon me, and that a blessing. And his mother said unto him, Upon me be thy curse, my son. Only obey my voice, and go fetch me them. And he went and fetched, and brought them to his mother. And his mother made savory meat, such as his father loved. And Rebekah took goodly raiment of her eldest son Esau, which were with her in the house, and put them upon Jacob, her younger son. And she put the skins of the kids of the goats upon his hands, and upon the smooth of his neck. And she gave the savory meat and the bread which he had prepared into the hand of her son Jacob. And he came unto his father and said, My father. And he said, Here am I. Who art thou, my son? And Jacob said unto his father, I am Esau the firstborn. I have done according as thou bidest me. Arise. Arise, I pray thee, sit and eat of my venison, that thy soul may bless me. And Isaac said unto his son, How is it that thou hast found it so quickly, my son? And he said, Because the Lord thy God brought it to me. And Isaac said unto Jacob, Come here, I pray thee, that I may feel thee, my son, whether thou be my very son Esau or not. And Jacob went near unto Isaac his father, and he felt him, and said, The voice is Jacob's voice, but the hands are the hands of Esau. And he discerned him not, because his hands were hairy as his brother Esau's hands. So he blessed him. And he said, Art thou my very son Esau? And he said, I am. And he said, Bring it near to me, and I will eat of my son's venison, that my soul may bless thee. And he brought it near to him, and he did eat, and he brought him wine, and he drank. And his father Isaac said unto him, Come near now, and kiss me, my son. And he came near and kissed him, and he smelled the smell of his raiment, and blessed him, and said, See, the smell of my son is as the smell of a field which the Lord has had blessed. Therefore God give thee of the dew of heaven, and the fatness of the earth, and plenty of corn and wine. Let people serve thee, and nations bow down to thee. Be lord over thy brethren, and let thy mother's sons bow down to thee. Cursed be every one that curseth thee, and blessed be he that blesseth thee. And it came to pass, as soon as Isaac had made an end of blessing Jacob, and Jacob was yet scarce gone out from the presence of Isaac his father, that Esau his brother came in from his hunting. And he also had made savory meat, and brought it unto his father, and said unto his father, Let my father arise, and eat of his son's venison, that thy soul may bless me. And Isaac his father said unto him, Who art thou? And he said, I am thy son, thy firstborn Esau. And Isaac trembled very exceedingly, and said, Who? Where is he that had taken venison, and brought it me? And I have eaten of all before thou camest, and have blessed him. Yea, and he shall be blessed. And when Esau heard the words of his father, he cried with a great and exceeding bitter cry, and said unto his father, Bless me, even me also, O my father. And he said, Thy brother came with subtlety, and had taken away thy blessing. And he said, Is not he rightly named Jacob? For he had supplanted me these two times, he took away my birthright. And behold, now he hath taken away my blessing. And he said, Hast thou not reserved a blessing for me? And Isaac answered and said unto Esau, Behold, I have made him thy lord, and all his brethren have I given to him for servants. And with corn and wine have I sustained him, and what shall I do now unto thee, my son? And Esau said unto his father, Hast thou but one blessing, my father? Bless me even also, O my father. And Esau lifted up his voice and wept. And Isaac his father answered and said unto him, Behold, thy dwelling shall be the fatness of the earth, and of the dew of heaven from above. And by thy sword shalt thou live, and shalt serve thy brother, and it shall come to pass when thou shalt have the dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck. And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, The day is a mourning for my father at hand. Then will I slay my brother Jacob. Now these words of Esau, her elder son, were told to Rebekah, and she sent and called Jacob her younger son, and said unto him, Behold, thy brother Esau is such indeed, doth comfort himself, pursuing to kill thee. Now therefore, my son, obey my voice, and arise. Flee thou to Laban, my brother, to Haran, and tarry with him a few days, until thy brother's fury turn away, until thy brother's anger turn away from thee, and he forget the which thou hast done to him. Then I will send and fetch thee from thence. Why should I be deprived also of you both in one day? And Rebekah said to Isaac, I am weary of my life because of the daughters of Heth. If Jacob take a wife of the daughters of Heth, such as these which are of the daughters of the land, what good shall my life do to me? Chapter 28. And Isaac called Jacob, and blessed him, and charged him, and said unto him, Thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan. Arise, go to Padan Aram, to the house of Bethuel, thy mother's father, and take thee a wife from thence of the daughters of Laban, their mother's brother. And God Almighty bless thee, and make thee fruitful, and multiply thee, that thou mayest be a multitude of people, and give thee the blessing of Abraham to thee, and to thy seed with thee, that thou mayest inherit the land wherein thou art a stranger, which God gave unto Abraham. And Isaac sent away Jacob, and he went to Padan Aram unto Laban, son of Bethuel the Syrian, the brother of Rebekah, Jacob's and Esau's mother. When Esau saw that Isaac had blessed Jacob and sent him away to Padan Aram to take him a wife from thence, and that as he blessed him, he gave him a charge, saying, Thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan. And that Jacob obeyed his father and his mother, and was gone to Padan Aram. And Esau, seeing that the daughters of Canaan pleased not Isaac his father, then went Esau unto Ishmael, and took unto the wives which he had Mahalath, the daughter of Ishmael, Abram's son, the sister of Nebajoth, to be his wife. And Jacob went out from Beersheba, and went toward Haran. And he lighted up at a certain place and tarried there all night, because the sun was set. And he took up the stones of that place and put them for his pillows, and lay down in that place to sleep. And he dreamed, and behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven, and behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it. And behold, the Lord stood above it, and said, I am the Lord God of Abraham thy father, and the God of Isaac, the land wherein thou liest, to thee will I give it into thy seed. And thy seed shall be as the dust of the earth, and thou shalt spread abroad to the west, and to the east, and to the north, and to the south, and in thee and in thy seed shall all the families of the earth be blessed. And behold, I am with thee, and will keep thee in all places whither thou goest, and will bring thee again into this land, for I will not leave thee until I have done which I have spoken to thee of. And Jacob awaked out of his sleep, and he said, Surely the Lord is in this place, and I knew it not. And he was afraid and said, How dreadful is this place! This is none other but the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. And Jacob rose up early in the morning, and took the stone that he had put for his pillows, and set it out for a pillar, and poured oil upon the top of it. And he called the name of that place Bethel, but the name of that city was called Luz at the first. And Jacob vowed a vow, saying, If God will be with me, and will keep me in this way that I go, and will give me bread to eat and raiment to put on, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then shall the Lord be my God. And this stone which I have set for a pillar shall be God's house, and of all that thou shalt give me, I will surely give the tenth unto thee. Okay, so chapter 27, basically ito yung si Isaac, akala niya malapit na siya mamatay. So sinabihan niya si Esau. Si Esau yung favorite niya between Esau and Jacob. So gusto niyang i-bless si Esau. Pero sabi niya, dalhan mo muna ako ng venison, tapos pagkakain ko, sa akin tayo i-bless. Pero ito, narinig to ni Rebecca. So sinabi niya kay Jacob, tapos sinutusan na niya si Jacob na kumuha ng goats, tapos lulutuin niya, papakain nila kay Isaac. Pero ito nga, sabi ni Jacob, baka mahuli tayo ni Isaac kasi si Esau is hairy man, pero si Jacob ay smooth yung kanyang skin. Tapos sabi ni Rebecca, siya nang bahala, yung balat ng goats nilagay kay Jacob para nung hinawakan siya ni Isaac, yun, ang nahawakan ay hairy yung kanyang skin. Pero nga, sabi rin ni Jacob, parang gusto niya rin tumanggi kasi, di ba, parang lolokohin nila si Isaac. Baka siya ay, instead of blessing, siya ay i-curse ni Isaac. So, pero yun, sabi ni Rebecca, kung ano man yung maging curse sa'yo, kung mangyari man yun, sa kanya mapunta yung curse, hindi dun sa kanyang anak ni si Jacob. Kasi nga, di ba, favorite ni Isaac si Esau, pero si Rebecca ang favorite niya ay si Jacob. Ayan. So, you know, you have your example here of parents showing favoritism to their kids, which is not good kasi nga, biglang nagkakagalit yung magkapatid, di ba? So, dito, nung nabless na ni Isaac si Jacob, saka dumating si Esau. Ngayon, si Esau, yun, nalaman nila yung ginawa ni Rebecca and Jacob. So, si Esau ngayon, naghahanap. Wala na pang ibang blessing dyan. Wala lang natitirang blessing. Ayan. So, binless pa rin naman siya ni Isaac kahit paano. Pero, syempre, ang ending nun is, Esau would still have to serve Jacob. Okay. So, in that case, Esau hated Jacob even more. Kasi, di ba, nung una, naipagbenta niya yung birthright niya kay Jacob. And then, ngayon, yung blessing is inagaw sa kanya ni Jacob. Ayan. So, si Esau, sa galit niya, naisip niya na patayin yung kanyang kapatid na si Jacob. Narinig din to ni Rebecca. So, ngayon, pinaalis niya si Jacob. Pinapunta dun sa kanyang kapatid sa Haran. Okay? And then, chapter 28, ayan na. Umalis na si Jacob. Pero itong si Esau, narinig niya na ayaw ni Isaac and Rebecca na makapangasawa si Jacob ng taga-Kinan. Okay? I don't know, pero parang to spite their parents, ang ginawa ni Esau, ginawa niya yung ayaw ng kanyang mga magulang. Kasi gusto niya makapangasawa ng daughters of Canaan. Ayan. So, eto naman si Jacob. Di umalis na siya. Tapos, meron siyang napuntahang lugar. Doon siya natulog. Tapos, nakapanaginip siya nga ng napanaginip niya ang Panginoon. Okay. Tapos, nung magising siya, di, sabi niya, surely this is the house of God, the gate of heaven. Tapos yun, meron siyang nag-vow siya, tapos yung ending nun is, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then shall the Lord be my God. So, umaga, during his life, hindi pa niya nare-recognize ang Panginoon bilang sarili niya, Panginoon. Ang alam niya lang niya is, Panginoon siya ni, yung Panginoon na yun, Panginoon yun ni Abraham, ni Isaac, pero siya, hindi pa niya tinatanggap bilang Panginoon. Okay. Pero nitong napaka-panaginip siya, nakausap siya ng Panginoon, tapos nag-salita siya ng vow. Yun, kumbaga sabi niya is, if God will be with me and will keep me in this way that I go, and will give me breath to eat and raiment to put on, so that I come again to my father's house in peace, then shall the Lord be my God. So, kumbaga dito pa lang niya, i-acknowledge na ang Diyos na kinikilala ni Abraham and Isaac ay siya rin magiging Diyos niya. Okay? Tapos, itong last, and of all that thou shalt give me, I will surely give the tenth unto thee. Okay? Ito yung tithes. Okay? Before, di ba, in earlier chapters, si Abraham give tithes of all. Tapos, ito, chapter 28, si Jacob naman. Ano? Kung ano daw yung ibibigay sa kanya ng Panginoon, ibabalik niya yung tenth unto thee. Okay? So, yan na, tithing din. Okay, and then we have Matthew chapter 8, verses 18 to 34. Okay, Matthew 8, verse 18. Now when Jesus saw great multitudes about him, he gave commandment to depart unto the other side. And a certain scribe came and said unto him, Master, I will follow thee whithersoever thou goest. And Jesus saith unto him, The foxes have holes, and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man had not where to lay his head. And another of his disciples said unto him, Lord, suffer me first to go and bury my father. But Jesus said unto him, Follow me, and let the dead bury their dead. And when he was entered into a ship, his disciples followed him. And behold, there arose a great tempest in the sea, insomuch that the ship was covered with the waves, but he was asleep. And his disciples came to him and awoke him, saying, Lord, save us, we perish. And he saith unto them, Why are ye fearful, O ye of little faith? Then he arose and rebuked the winds and the sea, and there was a great calm. But the men marveled, saying, What manner of man is this, that even the winds and the sea obey him? And when he was come to the other side, into the country of the Gergesenes, there met him two possessed with devils coming out of the tombs, exceeding fierce, so that no man might pass by that way. And behold, they cried out, saying, What have we to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of God? Art thou come hither to torment us before the time? There was a good way off from them, and earth with many swine feeding. So the devils besought him, saying, If thou cast us out, suffer us to go away into the earth of swine. And he said unto them, Go. And when they were come out, they went into the earth of swine. And behold, the whole earth of swine ran violently down a steep place into the sea, and perished in the waters. And they that kept them fled, and went their ways into the city, and told everything, and what was befallen to the possessed of the devils. And behold, the whole city came out to meet Jesus. And when they saw him, they besought him that he would depart out of their coast. Okay, so dito naman, makita natin si Jesus. Sinabi niya, tawag dito. The foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man have not where to lay his head. Kasi siya dito ay, kumbaga, nagpapa-uli-uli, ano. He goes from one place to another para mangaral ng salita ng Diyos, para magpagaling ng mga may sakit, para mangaral. Pero mainly mangaral. Ano. And then, sumakay sila nga ng ship, tapos, parang may bagyo, ganyan, malakas ang hangin. Yung ship na sakay nila is, masyadong, kumbaga, hindi stable kasi nga, there are great waves, ano. Tapos yung mga disciples niya, natakot, baka sila ay lumubog, ano, baka lumubog yung ship na sinasakyan nila. So, ginising nila yung ang Panginoon, di ba si Jesus, very calm lang siya. Nagawa pa niyang matulog dun sa ganung situation. Kasi alam niya na, hindi naman siya mapapahamak. Okay, tapos sabi niya, why are you fearful, O ye of little faith? Tapos yan, gumising siya, tapos nirebuke niya yung winds and the sea, tapos nagkaroon ng great calm. And yung mga kasama niya sa ship, yun namang hassle kasi anong klaseng tao daw ito, bakit pati yung hangin sa yung karagatan ay sinusunod siya. Ayan, tapos napunta siya dun sa other side ng country, ay meron siyang na-meet na dalawang tao, possessed with devils, tapos sinabi sa kanya, pwede bang, syempre, papalisin niya yung devils dun sa mga tao, ano? So, sabi ng devils, if thou castest out, suffer us to go away into the herd of swine. So, yan, sabi niya, go. And when they were come out, napunta sila dun sa herd of swine, mga baboy, ano. Tapos, yung whole herd of swine, tumakbo down a steep place into the sea. So, nahulog sa dagat, ano. Tapos, namatay yung mga baboy kasi pumunta sa karagatan, ano, sa waters, nalunod. Tapos, ayun, si Jesus Christ, saka yung dalawang tao na nawala na yung devils, ano, di na maayos na yung dalawang tao. Etong mga tao dun sa city na yun, narinig nila kung ano yung nangyari. Pero, sa halip ba na mamangha sila at tanggapin nila si Jesus Christ, sa nangyari, natakot sila. At ayaw nila na andun si Jesus. Ano. They besought him that he would depart out of their coast. Siguro ano, kasi yung may-ari ng swine, ng mga hayop, siguro inalagaan na yun para ibenta. Siguro yun yung kinakabuhay niya. Siguro ano, parang nagalit siguro siya or nainis. Kasi di ba yung mga inalagaan niyang hayop, nangamatay. Kaya, so, and siguro yung ibang tao na may mga alaga ring hayop, ayaw nila na matulad dun sa herd of swine yung kanilang mga inaalagaan. So, ayaw nila na andun si Jesus Christ. Or maybe some other reason. Pero I think that's one of the reason. Ano, one of the reasons. Okay. So, yun. And that else. So, yun. So, for now, yun lang muna. Siguro additional reflections in the coming days. Ano, so, I would still digest the content of the text that we've read today. Sometimes, hindi naman direct agad na, ay, applicable or something may alala ka na you can relate to the text. Ano. Sometimes, it will take a while. Ayan. So, thank you for joining me today. Hopefully, you also read your Bible daily. So, for today, again, text natin Genesis chapters 27 to 28, Matthew chapter 8, verses 18 to 34. So, that's it for today. Have a blessed day ahead.